hope you're all doing good. I've gotten some requests over on my Instagram and also here as well for just an updated video on some of the books that I have been loving as far as motherhood, Christian, just encouraging books for moms and women. And so I wanted to jump on here. I have been doing some filming. I had a couple videos for a couple different companies that I had to get done, as well as just some time to film for you guys today. So I wanted to share with you some of the books that I have been loving right now, as well as just some tried and true favorite books that I have just found really encouraging for being a mom. All right, so the first one, I cannot do a video on motherhood or on encouraging mom books that I've read without mentioning Deep Breaths by Michelle Pearson. Michelle is just such an encouragement. If you guys don't know, Michelle's a vlogger here on YouTube, and she is a mom of 5 kids. She's got twin girls that are under the age of 1. I love Michelle. She is someone that is such an encouragement to me. We're a lot alike. I got the privilege of being able to share in this book my thoughts on it and just on Michelle. And so that was fun to be able to contribute. But she put so much time and energy and love and prayer into this book. It's not only an encouragement to new moms, it's called Deep Breaths because, right, we all need to freaking take a deep breath sometimes. But it's also really great for just moms that need some encouragement and need to be reminded of the important things. There's really good exercises in here for you to write in. I'm always note-taking or journaling when I'm reading books, so to have that in here is super good. The next book is by Gloria Furman. This is called Missional Motherhood. And if you guys are familiar with my channel, I've shared another book by Gloria Furman that I'll share again today, actually. But she has done such an amazing testimony. She's got such a way of encouraging and also discipling and challenging, but it's so loving, and she shares so much of her own journey in her books that it's just like you're sitting down and listening to someone and just having heart to heart about sometimes motherhood is hard, and sometimes God calls us to a place that's not easy, but it's worth it. And Gloria is just, she's such a good spirit and such a beautiful soul. So Missional Motherhood is really good. I feel like that's a really good book to be reminded of our calling as moms, to be reminded of the greater calling that God's put on our hearts and our lives. This is really good. Also, Treasuring Christ When Your Hands Are Full. This was the very first book I ever read after becoming a mom. That was an encouraging book on motherhood. My husband bought this for me, and I fell in love with it. And so this is something, I've picked this book up so many times and just reread it. I recommend this book to like every mom. If you follow me on Instagram, I've given this book away before. It's so, so good. So Missional Motherhood and Treasuring Christ When Your Hands Are Full are both books that I love from Gloria Furman. This next book, actually both of these books, yeah, Desperate, I've shared before with you guys. You probably heard of this, Desperate. This is from Sarah May and Sally Clarkson. This is Hope for the Mom Who Needs to Breathe. This is so, so good. I feel like this is a book where you'll read it and you'll be like, I'm not alone. There are other moms out there that are going, every mom is going through what I'm going through at some point, and especially living in this 21st century, and the comparison trap of Instagram and social media and all of that. What, Peanut? What? Desperate is really good. When I was going through some of my darkest parts of postpartum after Jude, Lydia Sen here on YouTube, Lydia is such a good spirit. What? Can I talk? I know, she's like, no mom, you're talking too much. You're talking too much. I'm burping over here. I'm puking. I'm doing all the things while you're trying to do your video. Yeah, but you're so cute. Anyways, Lydia sent me this, and this was such a light for me in a dark time. And so I would recommend Desperate from Sarah May and Sally Clarkson. They also wrote The Life-Giving Home, which is something I have been currently reading. This is Creating a Place of Belonging and Becoming, Secrets to Making Home the Place Your Family Longs to Be. If you come from any kind of broken home, if you come from, even if you don't come from a broken home and you just want some encouragement on how to cultivate a home environment that is loving and is peaceful, I would definitely recommend that. My parents divorced when I was actually in high school. I've never shared my testimony, but this has been something that I've really desired to know how to do. How do I cultivate a Christian home? How do I cultivate a home where there's a legacy of love and honor and of a safe place of belonging for my kids? How do I do that? I feel like this is good because it shares both spiritual and also practical things that you can implement in your home just to make it more of a home. I've been loving this book. I have not finished this book. I'm in the middle of it right now and I've really been liking it. The next book that I have been liking, you probably have heard of as well, and this is called Present Over Perfect. This is from Shauna Nyquist. And this, I love her style of writing. It actually reminds me a lot of Jen Hatmaker, if you've read Seven or any of her books. It's very much raw and real. She shares very candidly and just speaks life. It says, leaving behind frantic for a simpler, more soulful way of living. So she just kind of shares, she reaches a point in her life where she knows she's not living a way that she wants to live, and something's got to change. And so, Present Over Perfect. The last one is my favorite. This is the Christian Homemaker's Handbook. My husband bought this for me right after I had my daughter, which I look back, I had my very first baby, and he bought me this book. And it's got such amazing contributions and forewords from amazing people that are like, this book is really legit, so you should read it. And so my husband bought it for me, and I love this book. This book covers everything from raising children to taking care of your home to training your kids, nurturing them, teaching life management skills to your family. It talks about like cleaning routines. I mean, practical, spiritual. It's a handbook. Like, it's so good, but it also has testimony and stories of the people that wrote this book, that contributed to this book. They also share like their own stories and their own experiences and advice and things. I love this book. I would recommend this book for kind of any homemaker, any woman that's a Christian and is a homemaker. I mean, this is a thick book, but this is definitely one of my favorites. And I have gotten so many of you guys tell me that you guys have gotten this book. Back when I shared that book, I think a couple years ago on my channel, and I still get messages and stuff from you guys saying like, this book is so good. I just went and got it and I'm obsessed with it. It's just a really good book. Those are some of my favorites. I'm sure there are more, but this little peanut is done. But those are the ones that stood out to me when I was looking at my collection of books. And I think I have a couple more on Kindle. You say hi. I know she's done. She's like, Mom, I'm done. I know. Oh boy. Look at those eyes. Look at those eyes, Peanut. Hi, Pumpkin. You look really red on here. I don't know why. So that's my list of books that I wanted to share with you guys today. I hope you enjoyed it. If there are any books that you love and you find encouraging, please comment down below and share them with us. I always love finding new books, and I know all of you guys love finding them too, and just being able to share in the comments. So definitely do down below. I love you guys. If you're not subscribed, please subscribe so we can get to know each other better. And little Miss Ingrid wants to nurse again and then go to bed. So I'm gonna let you guys go. Thanks so much for watching, and I will see you guys later. Bye.